We are back. We're doing another recording of Alan Wake. Got some flare gun ammo. Let's load that shit in. We can drop this off. And that's about it. We can also drop this off. Closer. Of course, this is the one I have maxed out. Yes, it is.
How's the memory doing?
Sorry, who are you?
Kidding.
Good to see you, Tim.
You had me going.
Cozy place you got here.
You know, your disappearance from Bright Falls is still the only thing that folks talk about. Well, that and Deerfest.
I'm about to say Deerfest.
Is this where you ended up back in 2010?
You know about that?
Well, I am the sheriff of Bright Falls. Or I was.
Are you related to Sarah Breaker? She was the sheriff of Bright Falls back in 2010.
Yeah, she's my cousin. I had a police sketch made of Dor based on my dreams. I sent it around and Sarah recognized the face from an old case file from the 80s. I moved out there to look into it and became sheriff after she left to join the feds.
So Deerfest is still a thing?
Oh yeah. Yeah, it's bigger than ever. You know, I got zapped here right before it was about to happen.
Funny, me too. What was in the case file about Dor?
Not a lot of details in it. A local man named Warland Dor went missing near Cauldron Lake. Eyewitnesses claim he was struck by a bolt of lightning and just vanished. I never found any official records of a Warland Dor living in town or anywhere. Another dead end.
And every single time his file expands too.
Thank you.
could see the Ocean View Hotel. I was getting close.
Secret is here.
The lights affected where the door led to.
That's right. Now here's actually where you normally would get the rifle. Right in here. Right in that, right there. Now the important thing to remember here.
The barman, you caught my eye.
It's the Ocean View cocktail, $25.50. Set the pin for the door, $25.50. We are now in the hotel. And I forgot to hit the timer. I'm at 8 minutes. We'll call it 10. Like, I'm such an idiot.
The room was empty except for the projector. More games. Was the film a message waiting to be played? Thank you.
In this temple of shadow and mist, there's a window in the floor and a door in the ceiling. There's no knowing. Am I standing still or running or kneeling?
You're the one who's been calling me.
Indeed. I'm Tom Zane. Welcome to the House of Zane.
The poet. The diver. You look like me. How the hell?
Or maybe you look like me, you handsome devil. The diver was a beloved character I played in one of my films. I'm a filmmaker. A celebrated auteur.
I need answers. Why is return so important? What?
You always get worked up like this. Come on, I'll fix you a drink. You and me, Alan, we're in this together. Two artists collaborating, remember? Crafting the keys to our escape. Your magnum opus, Return, and its companion piece, my film. Sharing our life-altering visions, a melding of higher minds. Dreaming up our transcendental work of art. Here, in this room.
In this room. In this room. In this room. In this room. In this room.
It's return, but because we return.
And that is how the magic happened.
Enough of this bullshit. Alice is in danger. I need another murder site to go further. Back to Parliament Tower. Scratches!
Your wife is safe back in the real New York. But Scratch is reaching for her through an overlap. Return is the key to escaping the dark place. You need to get it before that freak does. There's a murder site here in the hotel. Let the waves of your writing carry you there.
Hello?
They're on to us. If anyone asks, you were never here.
Thomas Zane had ended our talk in what felt like a paranoid fit. I had what I needed from him. There was another murder site in the hotel to guide me further toward my escape. I had to write my way to it.
Yeah, he's a Looney Tunes.
Whispers from the police radio kept me awake at night. The word through the ether. A murder in the backdrop of a play featuring a murder cult. How meta can you get? He said, looking knowingly at the camera. I could sense the cult of the word in this, and their leader, Mr. Scratch. Rumored to be Alan Wake, the writer who'd gone missing years before.
The hotel was a perfect setting for a Casey story. I was on the right path. I would start at the entrance lobby. The entrance hall set the mood, where everyone had come in. The victim, the murderer, the detective. An idea, clear as a vision, waited for me here.
So you were the director of this play?
Yeah, that's me. Our performance of the cult was cursed from the pre-show ritual on. The cult is an immersive theatrical experience.
Uh-huh. You're gonna have to walk me through what that means.
Immersive theater. A play where the audience can participate, spread across this hotel. The cult is a legend. The only written copy of the manuscript lost, the play is passed on as oral tradition between theater companies. Each company only performs it once. The play was said to have special power.
Oh, yeah.
You were like kids playing with a Ouija board. And when you call for the devil, he will come.
The pre-show ritual. That's it. Set it up. Start from the beginning. Layers upon layers. A play about a murder cult infiltrated by a real murder cult. I couldn't get in. I was missing something.
Some people would call it a key.
The room at the end of the corridor was closed off. It felt significant. Something terrible would happen there. The troop were busy building their own Wicker Man, where they themselves would be sacrificed. The prop room had been changed from room 104 to room 225.
Now here's where the weird thing happens. It took me a little while, I must admit, to understand this, so watch. We're in 104. We're in 205. Yeah, it's like a magic gateway. That threw me through a loop the first time I played.
A writer trapped in a dream world attempts to write a story to shape reality around him and escape. He is beset by visions leaking in from realities beyond his own. He uses those visions as inspiration for his story, in hopes of giving them power to make them come true. Us, hidden few, know that ultimately he will succeed. But before that, many of his stories collapse back into the stuff that dreams are made of, to remain as they began, works of fiction. And yet, maybe there is a gleam of truth to be unearthed from these tales. A rare glimpse into the unseen realities beyond our own, offering us intriguing avenues of contemplation as they transpire in the night spring.
So I believe Night Springs is the name of the first DLC.
This is where they gathered before the play. This is where it began. Another vision. Another
Why set up a play in a hotel?
And why this hotel?
Because the rent is cheap? No. The ocean view was perfect for this. It's said to be haunted. Dark stories about murder, death, suicide. Supposedly, an actual cult once performed an unspeakable ritual to summon something in the ballroom. Did we summon the same thing? Tapped into something horrifying? It seemed like it was part of the play, but it wasn't. Does that sound crazy?
You don't want to ask me about crazy, kid.
A haunted hotel, yes. That's a trope for a reason.
Oh, yeah.
The ballroom would be the stage of a key scene in the play. My writing was affecting reality.
I think I actually have to do some, yeah, gotta put this in there, and one more of these. Gotta remember I have those grenades. I'm going to quick slot them down there.
I recognized my writer's room on the stage. I had the ideas this would conjure up.
Nice set you got here. What was the scene in this room?
Well, this is what we call the writer's room. In the play, it's where the devil rewrites reality whilst God is asleep. The devil was our star role. I got a big-time celebrity to play him, and he was method acting the role to perfection. He never broke character, always wore the cult mask. His name was scratched out on the posters.
Mm-hmm. And who was this mystery celebrity? Let me guess, Alan Wake?
I wish I could tell you, but turns out there were masks upon masks. whoever he really was? Shit got weird when he was around. Some of the crew joked that we'd actually hired the devil to play himself.
Mr. Scratch is the devil. He was born to play the role.
I had to agree with Casey on that.
Of action, aid, or okay, yeah, still need the majority to complete. The devil.
This was dark, but the story had to be dark. Writing. This is Scratch mocking me. I didn't have the key.
I actually don't think I've ever visited him in the hotel. Okay, this is another character from Mom.
This is Dr. Casper Darling, formerly of the Federal Bureau of Control. I think the signal is coming through now. Are you receiving me? Something shifted. The previously observed interference disrupting my broadcast has got fluctuation in gravitational forces. Either something moved out of the way or my relative position to a change, but the alignment and or the condition of this whole plane spiraled to a more favorable position. The ordinary rules of reality do not apply here. Best I can describe, this place is a dreamscape. But who's the dreamer? And how do you wake up from this dream? I've been taking readings with the limited equipment I've been able to secure. Some riveting data accumulating. Hypotheses taking shape. My struggle with this, that the way this place works makes any hypothesis immediately come back to alter and contaminate the data. Anyway, I've been working to capture and isolate and amplify certain frequencies from the background radiation ambient noise, so let's see what happens.
Thank you. voice of the dreamer. What's strange is it sounds a little bit like my voice.
It was locked from the other side.
God, it is strange. It does sound like your voice.
Hey, Tim. New map, huh?
Yep. Look, I've never been to New York, but I can tell you that this ain't it.
I heard you humming again.
Yeah, I can't get this song out of my head. It's a real earworm. I hear it in my dreams.
I know that song you keep humming. It's the theme from Night Springs.
That old sci-fi show?
Sci-fi horror anthology. I used to write for a long time ago.
Look, it sounds a bit nuts, but I think the song is connected to Door. Or, it's my subconscious telling me that this is all pretty out there.
I think I have to go back to the first floor at this point. Oh shit. On that note, we'll see you guys in the next episode. Peace out.